Work ethic is when you just sit down and you stare at something for about an hour. This is the most effective way to study, is to do it continuously over a certain period of time. Do not half do two things, whole do one thing. And you can see this is a very effective work ethic in the Germans, who are, of course, you know, very renowned for their engineering. They would work 9 to 5, no Facebook, no nothing. Of course, we live in a world where we have lots of distractions. It's like we're a very OCD generation. We have Facebook, Twitter, and oh God, WhatsApp. Well, that's the worst right there. You get on WhatsApp and just go on and on and on. But the best impactful way to get things done is to stare at it continuously. You focus, focus, focus for 1 hour. Doing it for 1 hour is more effectively than half-half for 2 hours. Because you end up getting, if you half-half, if you like study while, you know, you got your notes here and you've got something else here, you end up wasting some time, you end up wasting more time, and you don't get a lot done. And this tip actually applies to a lot of the other things you do in life. If you're running a business or if you're a scientist, focus, that's the key. It's a characteristic of a lot of successful people out there. Sustained release, you know, focus. Of course, it's a lot of bad habits. Sometimes we don't practice it all the time, but I'm suggesting that if you want to succeed, this is one of the essential things to do. Okay, life tip. When in doubt, slow down and write it down. Like I said, I was off to a rocky start in my first year, first semester. And I actually did not, because of this, I ended up not following the course structure. I was legitimately scared that I would never ever finish engineering in my first year. But then as I got further and further along the program, it became a matter of not if I graduate, but when. And when I graduate, because it would happen eventually. Because at the first part I thought, oh man, I'm never going to get over this. But when I slowed down some of my other commitments in life. Of course, you got a lot of, you know, you do sports, which is also a really good thing to do. You do videos. I make videos on the internet. And sometimes I would even take less subjects, you know, to slow down, really just get my own pace for it. And then only when I'm feeling suitable enough, I would take more subjects. That was the sacrifice that I made. And of course, eventually that kind of came back and bit me in the posterior, because I ended up having to extend, but it's fine, it's fine. For a person who was like scared of the whole thing, but I managed to get through it. So if you have any habits about going out late at night and you know that you have an exam the next day, I know a lot of you young people like to explore and do a lot of things with your friends, you know, that's a completely human thing to do, it's not wrong. But if you know things are picking up, slow down. And about the writing down thing, personally, for myself, I am an output learner. I learn things by writing them down and looking at the picture like that. So what I did is whenever I would have a question or a diagram, I would write it down. The first time, I wouldn't even know what it means the first time. I just throw away that. I mean, I put that paper in a pile. And then I write it down the second time. Okay, now I'm slowly trying to get the hang of it. And by the third time, I would have gotten it down. That's called output learning. So everyone has their own method or way of effective learning. And for me, I'm an output learner. Writing it down really helps, because in engineering, like I said, the first tip, it's all about building mathematical models of things we find in our technology, or if we're doing math, nature, and whatnot. So write it down. This is a thing that some of the money tutors have a problem with. I have this guy under me. I'm a money tutor, by the way. Hello, everyone. Osu Benny James and some of the international students, they will say they know, but when I look at their paper, they haven't really written anything down. So I just tell them, dude, you just gotta write it down. I don't care, write it down. And that really helps them visualize things. Okay, next tip. Okay, success tips. Submit and attend everything. I should have right here, dot, 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 on time. I've known my friends, I've seen a lot of my friends that end up dealing with this thing where they have to replace their lab sessions. You should never, ever have to end up in a predicament where you have to replace your lab session. Always do it the first time and just get it done over with. Make your peace with God or whatever cosmic force of the universe you believe in. Just do it and get it over with. I've had a friend who's told me he's failed power electronics because he did not attend one of the major exams. I can't remember which one it was, whether it was the finals or the midterm. But he told me he's repeating power electronics. I'm like, why are you repeating? Oh, because the last time I took it, I did not attend the finals or the midterm. That No, okay? Always attend, always submit on time. And of course, how you say the classes, right? Always try to be present in the moment. Even if you're there to daydream, even if you're there to like, you're sleepy and you're gonna daydream, fine, as long as you're in class. Even if you're there to just smile at the lecturer, I know Mr. Gan's a very handsome fella, just go to class and just sit there, chilling and whatnot. I remember in my second year, first sem, we had an 8 o'clock Friday morning class for circuits and signals, which was very difficult for me to attend because number one is Friday morning and number two is 8 o'clock. Okay. I think Mr. Hairi was teaching me that time. And Mr. Hairi and Ms. Nisha, and it was in the XR. And every time I go in, I'd be at least 15 to 30 minutes late. When I get in, I would go to sleep immediately. My friend would see me from across the hall, from across the XR, and I would be sleeping like a Kung Fu master, like this. Just sleeping. But then by the second hour, I was okay. I was up and ready to go. Circuits and signals, got an A. High five. So yeah, submit and attempt everything, and do not end up in a predicament where you have to replace the lab. That's pointless. You have to fill up the forms and stuff like that. That's stupid. Okay, life tip: stay fit, stay sane, exercise. Okay, it works. It does wonders for.